Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about 1D array. For this lesson, you will learn what 1D arrays are as well as how to create and manipulate 1D arrays in Python. First of all, what is an array? An array is a data structure that stores a fixed size sequence of elements of the same type. And next, a 1D array is a linear collection of elements that can be accessed directly using an index. So the keyword here will be linear for 1D array. And furthermore, Python does not have a native support for arrays, but we can use list instead. It means that inside Python itself, we do not have this array data type. So normally, we will be using list to replace arrays. Bear in mind that lists in Python are dynamic, meaning that elements can be added or removed from them. This feature is not typically found in traditional arrays in other languages, but it offers more flexibility. So as I say, we do not have built-in array for Python. Therefore, we are using list, which has more flexibility. We can always add or remove things from the list itself. And why do we use arrays? First of all, we use array because it has efficient data storage and manipulation. Furthermore, it allows us to have quick access to specific elements due to indexing. So I'm pretty sure that you know that for arrays, we can always access the elements inside the array using index. Now let's look at how can we create a 1D array, which is list in Python. The first step will be this one here. List in Python can be created as mylist. So this is just a variable name equal to square bracket. So remember that for array, we are using square bracket here, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Basically, we are creating a list or an array with 5 elements inside, and they are all integers for now. Furthermore, list can hold different types of data. For example, mixed list is equal to 1, this is integer, and then 2, this is string, and then 3.0, this is float, and then 4, this is string, and then true is the boolean. So this only apply to list in Python. In general, for other programming languages, the data type for the array is always fixed. It's either like integer or boolean or string, but because we are using list to replace array in Python, this is pretty dynamic. And below here will be the example. For example, my list, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then mixed list, 1, 2, 3, 4, and true. Let's look at how can we create a zero initialized 1D arrays. In general, during your exam, sometimes the question may ask you to create a empty array first, and you can always use this method. For example, sometimes the question might ask you to write program code to declare a global 1D array, data array, with space for 100 integer value. It means that right now, we are just declaring the array first without putting any actual value inside. But for Python, we have to somehow have some placeholder in order to do that. Therefore, we can do something like this. We have two methods. The first method would be this one here. Data array equal to 0 for I in range 100. It means that from range 0 to 99, we actually putting 0 for each of the value. So we will be having this array here with 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 for 100 times. This is for method 1. And then let's say you find that this method 1 is a bit complicated to remember, you can use method 2 as well. So what you do here is that, first of all, you'll create an empty list first or empty array, depending on how you think it. So data array is equal to empty list, and then for I in range 100, data array dot append 0. So this is how you can actually append 100 0 into the list or the array. So you can use method 1 or method 2 depending on which one you prefer. After creating the array, how do you access the array elements? First of all, Python uses zero based index system. Definitely, when you learn from paper 2, the index always starts from 1, but for Python, or for most of the programming languages, the index always starts from 0. And next, access elements like so, my list bracket 0 will result in 1. For example, the first element in my list is 1. When we type my list bracket 0, we will be accessing the first element of the array. And next, negative indexing is possible. For example, my list negative 1 results in 5. Let's say this is my list store 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 is actually the last element of the array. When I type negative 1, I'm actually looking the array from the back. Therefore, this is how you can use negative indexing. And finally, let's look at this visualization to understand better. For example, I have my list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are all the elements inside my list. And the index starts from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then this is for the normal index. And let's say you want to access the last element of the array, you can do negative 1, second last, third last, fourth last, and then fifth last. So you can use either the normal index or the negative index. But in exam, in general, we will be using this normal index, which always starts from 0. Now let's look at some array operations. For example, this is the original array. And let's do some operation. The first operation will be modifying elements, which means changing certain value inside the list or the array. So how do you do that? It's actually quite simple. You can just do something like this. My list bracket 0 equal to 5. Let's look at my list 0 first. What is the value inside my list 0? It's actually 1. It means that right now, I'm updating this 1 into 5. And let's look at the result. So this is the result here. This 1 has been updated to 5 here. And the next operation will be adding elements known as push. So later on, we will be learning about stacks, which will talk more about push. And for now, you can just imagine that I'm adding a new element to the end of the array. So how do you do that? You can just do my list.append 10. And I actually show you the keyword append where we create the 0 initialize 1D array. So what will happen when I do my list.append 10 based on this array here? This will be the final result here. Basically, we are adding a new element to the end of the array, which is 10 here. The next operation will be removing elements. So how do you remove elements from an array? You can just do my list.remove bracket the value of the element. So after typing this remove file, what will happen? It will actually remove the first matching value. If you look at this example here, we have 2, 5. 5 here and 5 here. Since it removes the first matching value, it will actually remove this 5 here. Therefore, the final result is going to be this one here. My list 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. We have just removed the first element, which is 5 here, from the original array. Next operation will be remove element at a specific position. So how do you do that? You can just write my list.pop 3. So what does this 3 actually mean? It means that I'm actually removing the element at index 3. So what would be the element at index 3 based on this example here? So now let's go through this together. Index 0, index 1, index 2, and index 3. So by right, I should be removing the element 4 from the original array. And let's look at the final result here. It's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 5. Furthermore, if you want to remove the last element, you can just write my list.pop. So without the index, you are actually removing the last element from the array. So based on this array here, what will happen? The final result is gonna be this one here. My list 1, 2, 3. I have just removed the last element from the array using the pop method here. Remember that we learned about string slicing in the string manipulation lesson. We also can do the same for array. First of all, slicing allows us to get a subset of the list. We can actually just slice like this. For example, my list 1, colon 3 will result in 2 and 3. Why? Because we start from index 1 and we end at index 3 minus 1, which means that it's going to be index 1 and 2. Therefore, the answer is 2 and 3 using slicing. And next, in order to find the length of the list or array, we always use this built-in function. Length bracket my list will actually return 5. So why 5? Because we have 5 elements inside this array or list. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total will be 5 elements. Therefore, the length is also 5 here. The last topic would be, how do we loop over an array? The first thing that we do is create the 1D array. So this is how we can create a 1D array. My list is equal to square bracket 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then square bracket again. And next will be loop over the array. We have two methods that we can do to loop over the array. The first method will be this method here, for number in my list. So what does this line do? This line is actually iterating through every element inside the list. So this number can be anything. You can write I, number, j, or whatsoever. But based on this example, I'm just stating that this element is number. For example, number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, and etc. So this is just the element name. For number in my list, print number. So this is how we can loop over the array. And next, we also can do the other method, which is for index in range 0, 5. So why 0, 5? Because it starts from 0, index 0, and then ends at index 4. Therefore, the ending number has to be 4 plus 1. So let's go through this again. Index 0, index 1, index 2, index 3, index 4. Therefore, when you write this range function, you have to write 0, 5, not 0, 4, and then print my list square bracket index square bracket again, and then just close the bracket here. So what happens here is that instead of using this number here, I'm actually accessing the element based on the index, and the index will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So when we run either this code or this code, we will get the same output, which is this one here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the first one will be based on the element. So element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the second code is based on the index, which is index 0, index 1, index 2, index 3, index 4. So these are the two main methods that you can use to loop over an array. Now let's look at some lab to improve your understanding on 1D array. So the first task would be this one here. Create a 1D array of your 5 favorite foods and print them out using a loop. So this is pretty straightforward. And for lab 2 will be add another favorite food to the array and remove the first item from the array. So you add one food and then you remove the first item from the array. Finally, print out the new array using a loop. So this is for lab 2. The last lab will be print the first 3 foods, do not use a loop, from the array and find the length of the array. So this is for the final lab.